everyone, welcome to the class. Today I'm here with very creating and very interesting activity for you. You know, this is called mandala technique. You know what is the meaning of mandala? Mandala is a Sanskrit word and the meaning of this word is called circle. So this art is belongs to symbolic art, and when we do this art we enjoy a lot. And nowadays this art is very popular. Have many types, but here we are going to learn how to create dotted mandala. And dotted mandala is very interesting, and we have to use here small and big dots to create a colorful pattern on the paper. And we can use this pattern on stones, on some wooden and cardboard anything. You can create some effects like dotted mandala on the canvases also. Start with that. As you can see on my screen, there is a pattern which is dotted mandala pattern. You know why we call it mandala? As I told you in the beginning, mandala is a circle pattern where we can create a pattern inside the circle or outside the circle. What are material we require for this? Let's have a look. As you can see, I have created this pattern on black sheet. So as you can see, I have used black sheet under the pattern. So you can use black, you can use white, or you can use any other dark color of paper. So here we require black paper size sheet, acrylic colors, we need these toothpicks, they all easily available at home. We need these earbuds also. To create some small big dots, we need these two things, earbuds and toothpicks. And we need some like pencils to create some effects from the back side of the pencil. As you can see, the color is already there. We need tissue paper to create mandala like circle. So we need a compass, we need a water container, we need color palette. I have already poured my colors, whatever I want for my colorful painting. So these all things we require for doing this mandala art. So let's start. So here I have A4 size black sheet. Now I'm going to cut this black sheet, A4 size black sheet, into square piece. So here is my square piece. I have already cut it for you, and I have drawn a design also in this. So these half circles also come in mandala pattern. You might be thinking, it is not circle, so how come it is coming into mandala? This is also coming to the mandala. So now let's start with the activity. So first you need to think about it, what kind of pattern you make and what all colors you want to do it on that. After that you need to select the size of your dot. Here I have told you we are going to use 2-3 things to create big small dots. So as you can see, if I am using the back side of this pencil, can be a bigger dot. Earbud will be a smaller than that. And you know what, we can use this toothpick from both the sides. One is this and one is this side. So this will be a little thicker and this will be a very tiny dot which we can apply to create a very thin dot to give the variation. And we are using all these dots, all these size dots, to create a variation in our painting. Otherwise it will be look a very normal kind of a dot painting which we are learning from our childhood. Put the color in the earbud and put the dots like randomly. No, this is not a that kind of painting. It's little different from the painting which we were doing from so many years. It's a very beautiful artwork, very beautiful technique to do. So let's start doing it. So first, and you know what, here is a very important role of one color, that is white. White plays a very important role in this artwork. Basically this art style always used on dark surface. And you can see, if we want to show the colors little brighter, so we always take white to highlight them, like doing outlining with it and mixing it and make the pastel shades like lighter tones like peach, light blue, light green, light purple, light pink. So these all shades we create by mixing white. So as you can see, the surface is black, so for this surface we need bright colors. So first I'm going to put some dots. First, I'm going to use white color to start with my pattern. So here I'm dipping my biggest dot in white color. Here I'm making it here this white dot. Then I'm going to use smallest dot, like the tip of the toothpick, to create dots around. So these dots should be similar. They're not supposed to uneven. Even gap should be there. Like this. We create a pattern around. Now next, again, more small dots. You can take uneven dots also, small, big, and big, small, like that. So my one pattern is ready. Now I'm going to take another color. You can see I have taken orange for the bigger dot. One more important thing, you need to take a different earbud or toothpick for the different colors, and don't reprint and don't overprint on that. Once dot is done, let it be. Keep on doing this to create my pattern. How many dots you want to put, it's all up to you. You can take small, big dots all together. And I'm taking according to the space. I'll be keep on repeating with orange. I'll going to create two lines with the orange dots. Remember that color should not be too much watery, should be a little thicker, otherwise your dot will be not visible on the paper. So I'm taking one more time as I want. Only a little bit of pressing is enough to get a appropriate dot, like this. Keep on repeating the same pattern. So I have done with my orange. Now I'm planning to do green. So I'm taking next green dot. So if I want a bigger dot, so I'll press this little more. Keep on doing. So in between these thinner dots, I'm taking some thick dots. You know what I'm using? This is my brush, which I'm using to create the dot. So this is the back side of my brush, which I'm using. Can you see that? This is the front and this is the back. So I'm using back side of my brush to create the dot. And the pressure you're putting, that should be equal. The more pressure you put, the more thicker dot you will get. So equal pressure to get an equal size dot, and remember that the distance between the dot should be equal, not supposed to uneven, otherwise your pattern will not look nice. And one more thing, you need different earbuds, as I told you, for the different colors. You can't take one earbud or one toothpick for all the colors. You can't take it, otherwise you will not get the fresh look in in your artwork. They all will mix up. That gives a very dirty effect to your painting. So these all instructions you need to follow to get a good artwork. So and keep on repeating the pattern and keep on doing the same to get a desired pattern. So here I have done this much. Now I'm going to take a darker tone of this for getting the thicker. So I'm using earbud very carefully. As I have mixed white and this dark green color to get a brighter. As I told you, if I use this dark tone on my black paper, so that will be look so dark and the color will be not visible on that. So I have mixed white to give a lighter tone to the black. This style of painting will increase your concentration level and increase your patience level also, because it needs lot of patience and concentration. The moment you get distracted, your dots will be go here and there and your pattern will get spoiled and you will not get the desired pattern which you wanted to create on the paper. So for that you need patience. This activity will help you to increase that. And keep on doing the same with the equal distance dot like this. Now I'm going to use some other color. So here I'm planning to use white color to give little variation in the painting. So that will be the smaller dot. The moment you are using the white, the look of your painting is totally changed. Do it very carefully. Now I'm going to take a double layer of this white, little thicker. As I told you, this art only you need to use big small dots. I'll be highlighting these petals which I have created with small dots. And keep on telling. Tens should be equal. The moment you feel like the color is going, you can dip it again and then do it. You know what, acrylic color dries up very fast, so there will be no problem to take one or another color one by one. There will be no problem to take it. Keep on taking, keep on doing. So I can't wait for the color gets dry and then I'll take another. my colors are. Keep on drawing. We are using. So you need to complete this, the same pattern that they are doing. You can take your own design also. It's not necessary what I am making, you have to make the same. You are very creative, so you can create beautiful than me, you know, like this. Now I'm going to take this blue color to fill up the petals. You have to follow the shape around. Change the shade of blue. Now I'm taking a little darker tone. And small size dots. You can keep on doing like this. Dark light dark. Big small dots. I'm going to do this one as a petal also. Same way. Again the dark tone. Continue. Now again for the other petal, keep on doing the same way. You can do it like, you can complete first one with one color and then you can apply another color, so that will be a convenient and easy for you. First I am completing my pattern with light blue. Now come to the next. Took my dark tone here. Completing the pattern. On doing to the next. Again I repeat with my light blue color pattern. Done with this light blue. Now here I am using the other color, yes, light blue. After completing the one side of the pattern, I am going to turn my sheet to complete the other side of my pattern. For that pattern again I'm going to take white color here and then again start doing with pattern. So here I'm going to use different color scheme like orange, red, like that. So here I'm going to take yellow. On previous pattern I have taken white to create small dot around the circle, but here I'm taking yellow like this. So now I'm going to take a thicker dot of yellow. Changing my color, I'm going to make some patterns with orange. You can make it with the similar color scheme as well, but I want to show some variation in this pattern, so I'm taking a different color. Little more gap so I can take some thinner dots in between these two thicker dots. I'm going to take a red. Red color for making smaller dots in between. You can create these dots in between these yellow dots as well. Give little variation in shape. To create a thicker dot with red. Red color for making bigger dots. Distance. Give the variation the shade. I'm going to use thin white dots. Create some big painting also, but these big paintings will take time, but when you do it, it looks so beautiful. You can create cars, you can create coasters, mats, table mats, wall hanging, anything you want to make with these dots. You can create paperweights, you can paint your stones like you have, you can paint them and create some patterns with dots on them, and you can use them as a paperweight. You can paint flowers. Here also I'm using this to give the variation. Dots of red color I told you in the previous pattern. First you can complete with one color and then you can use another color. Or first you can do it like the way you want. You can do one by one all together. Again, as I have taken in the previous pattern, outline of the petals with white dots like that. In the same way, I'm doing it in this pattern also. Like this, with the equal stem dot. Same color, white. If you don't have earbuds or toothpicks at home, you can use any sharp thing like the old pen which is not working. You can take a pencil, any sharp thing you can take for making this small big doll. It's all up to you how you can use them. Now I'm using the color in the petals as I want to balance the green color in this whole painting, so I'm using it here also. Same way I have done it with light blue and dark blue in the previous pattern. And here also I'm using the same pattern by putting dark and light green in the patterns. How beautifully these colors are complementing each other and giving it a very nice look to the painting. Like this. Again, I'll repeat with light green as I told you. Inside portion. You can rotate your sheet accordingly as you feel comfortable. Like this. Feel like your color is getting dry, you can mix water. Now I am using blue to give little bit of similar look to the painting. Like the previous pattern we have done with blue, green, like that. So the color should be balanced. Thank you. the moment I apply white dot, you can see the painting suddenly becomes so bright. You know the reason why? Because of the surface. As we have taken the black surface, so on black surface, whatever light shade we are going to apply, it gives a brighter look to the painting. So every time whenever you choose the colors, please keep that in the mind, what is the color of your background. Accordingly, you have to choose the background and colors. Keep on using white to make it my painting bright. I'm going to give the white color dot on this orange big dot. Can you see? The moment I put the orange and on that we I'm putting this white dot, you can see the variation of the color. Now look at the effect. Now on the red. So I have done this. Our artwork is done, completed now. So you know what, not only on the paper, we can use this technique on some other material also. Like I have prepared few samples for you that I wanted to show you. See, I have prepared this paperweight. You know what is this? Stone. So I have done dots on stone. Like this, I have prepared few more. You know what is this? Can you tell me? This is the cardboard, and cardboard, which cardboard? I have done on, you know what, when we get a cake, there's a, under there's a plate, cardboard plate under your cake. So I have used that plate to create that. You have seen I have created only colorful, and here I have done only black and white. So like this I have done color also. See this one, can you see this? This is all geometrical mandala. So like this you can create many more and decorate your walls, tables, and or you can gift it to somebody. So that's all for the class. Hope you enjoyed the class. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. I'll be back with some more creative activities for you. Bye bye, take care, see you.